You know, Dorothy Jean Tillman II completed her associate's degree at age 10, a bachelor's degree at age 12. She picked up her double master's at 14, and last weekend she walked across the stage at Arizona State to receive her PhD, which she earned at 17 years old. What the?
I was setting things on fire with a magnifying glass. And she joins us in studio to talk about that in her camp, helping students here and in South Africa. Well, yes. Congratulations to you.
And you go by DJ?
Yes.
Well, and you are related to former alderwoman Dorothy Tillman.
Yes,
that's your grandma?
That's my grandmother, yes.
Oh, my gosh. So tell us, did your parents know pretty early on that you were an exceptional student, and what did they tell you about that?
I think my grandma, my granny, and my mom all kind of saw it in me, like, at different points in times, in different ways. And I kind of just thought, like, a lot of what we were doing was normal until it got, like, a different level of attention. And so I didn't notice it, but I think people around me did.
Uh-huh.
So when you're in a group of, like, 10-year-olds, are you just thinking, wow, these dopes are... What's going on?
10-year-olds, whenever I'm around, like, people younger than me, yeah. Like, even if it's just a year younger than me, even if it's, like, a couple months, I just love to, like, see myself in them, whether it was, like, myself a couple months ago, myself a couple years ago, and just see whatever it is that I could, like, understand them on. Because sometimes younger kids, I think it's, like, pushed to the side, even if it's on the simplest level of it being, like, a teen group, and they want to hang out. And I think I've been that kid, so I always want to, like, hang out with that kid.
Now, you were homeschooled, and I think the biggest criticism some people have is that maybe you don't get to do all the social things that kids in a regular school get to do. Do you find you missed out on any of that?
I think that's definitely a fair criticism, and I'm definitely, like, finding my own pathway, like, towards that. But I definitely think being a big social butterfly, that was one of my obstacles in homeschool.
Yeah, I mean, I would think is it your mom that homeschooled you all this
time? Yes, my mom homeschooled me, so.
And
she's
that's
my
a lot
superhero.
Of talking to your mom, right?
Yeah. I mean, yeah. And so it definitely took a lot of communication, but we're a good team.
So. Wow.
So your PhD is about mental health, do I have that right? And how do you apply that to the real world?
So I got my DBH, so it's a doctorate of behavioral health and integrated behavioral health on the management concentration. And so that's making sure that health facilities are as integrated as possible so that our mental health professionals and our physical primary care providers are in the same facilities working together for the best care possible provided for humans. And I just feel like that's such an important topic that young kids need to be educated on, that as I've gotten my degree, I've started to think of ways that I can integrate it with the work that I already do with youth.
So you're doing, talk about this camp you're doing. It's not a STEM camp, you call it a STEAM camp because there's an arts component to
yes.
it.
Yes, so okay. The Dorothy Jean STEAM Leadership Institute is a science, technology, engineering, arts, and math program because I felt like the right brain and the left brain needed that pathway to each other. There's an art in engineering and there's an art to technology, and I feel like somebody needed to shine a light on that while simultaneously shining a light on these students and providing them with a platform to get the resources that they feel like they need and the resources to find a pathway to their dreams and what they may want to do.
And people can just sign up for this, or do they go to a website?
Well, we are at capacity this year for the camp.
Oh my gosh.
But we can always use a little bit of extra help for field trips and all of the things that we do for the kids on a day-to-day basis.
And you got prom coming up?
I have prom coming up.
That's awesome. So some of those fun things you still get to do, right?
Yes.
Aww.
So I'm going with my best friend, and, like, that's the best thing ever after, like, all of this graduation stuff. This feels incredible, and I'm really grateful, but I'm also really happy to still be able to do things like
well,
that.
Well, we're great. So excited for you. Check back in with us, because we'll probably still be here in a couple years, and you'll be on to much better things. But don't.
Well, definitely
it's
be
wonderful to meet you.
It's
thanks so much.
Yeah. You guys.
Wow. We are such morons, Larry.
We're a couple of dopes.
Yeah.